we're seeing the multiverse concept in a lot of popular storytelling. There's the Marvel Cinematic Universe and then alternate timelines in the Star Trek films. So what exactly is the multiverse theory? And do you think it's likely we live in one?
The multiverse. So, well, part of the problem with giving a good answer to this is that there are many different things called the multiverse. You arrive at the idea that, for example, you know, our solar system isn't unique. There are many of them. Our galaxy isn't unique. There are many of them. And then pretty rapidly you're going, wait, maybe our universe isn't unique. So that's one way you arrive at the multiverse. The other way that's very common is thinking about quantum physics, when we discovered that you get probabilistic answers to certain things. You know, it's 50% chance you do this instead of that in your physics answer. You might go, well, maybe the other answer does happen as well, but in another universe. So that leads to the idea that the universe is constantly branching, making choices, and we live with one of those choices, but the others happen as well. And then you get to ask, well, are those things real? Are those other choices real? Or are they just in our imagination? Are they part of physics or are they not? And the answer is, right now in physics, people use multiverse scenarios, and there are other ways of coming up with multiverses too. People use multiverse scenarios as possibilities for understanding the universe, but right now it's speculative. There's no actual physical evidence that points definitely to there being a multiverse. But they're fun to play with, both in physics and, of course, in narrative. And you get to ask questions, you know, what if I did it that other way and things. So that's why I think we're attracted to it. But right now, there's no clear evidence that such a thing exists.